As a person who's on social media, you experience humor, nostalgia, love. There's already been research looking at things like anger and hate and how these negative emotions are associated with sharing. But there were a number of positive emotions that people don't ever measure. You know, the internet is made of cats, right? So why aren't people studying this?
European Union officials have issued a warning to TikTok about
disinformation, botnets to spread fake news.
Knowing that information travels fast on social, it's important to understand how it spreads. We worked in interdisciplinary teams. So we have linguists, computational linguists, statisticians, social psychologists. We all bring together the knowledge.
We're not the first to study emotion on social media, but a lot of the research is looking only at a small set of emotions. They don't cover all the emotions that are even relevant to social media. Envy,
nostalgia,
admiration, love,
wonder,
gratitude, relief. We can't understand what emotions are relevant to social media sharing or anything until we know what to measure and how to measure it. So a lot of our work has simply been in measuring.
We developed a guide for measuring the presence and the magnitude of emotions in social media posts. There is a lot of cuteness in here.
People are showing babies and cats and dogs in cute outfits. Of course, there's this emotion you get when you see adorable things.
We started exploring it, and we found out that it hasn't been defined, and there are no means to measure it.
Yes, okay.
The tongue is just so cute.
The eyes are pretty big, the ears are pretty big, particularly on the cow on the left.
As we looked at things, we realized we had a lot more questions about it than nobody had done. So is it that things look like babies? Is that what's driving sharing? Or is it that they're tumbling around or that they are soft and fluffy?
A lot of the research is very focused on this concept called baby schema. Things are cute because they look like mammal babies. They have the big head, they have the big eyes, the big ears. But we all know that there's a lot of other things that we constitute and call cute. We have the emotional reaction to them that it's cute.
So we developed the cuteness attributes taxonomy, or CAT. It's comprised of 15 items.
If I post a picture of my cute cats, other cat owners see that and go, this is a person I might want to interact with. So it's a way of starting a relationship. People post like, I'm having a bad day. Can you send me pictures of your pets? And they're using it for emotional regulation purposes. And this work is trying to encapsulate more of those human behaviors that make up social media in ways that we don't currently understand.
There's a lot of people who use social media to persuade and to manipulate, and some of that's more relatively benign than others.
Masks are adorable. So many dumb
ways to die. Only you.
But you could also see that people use it in the information war space.
Years ago, ISIS fighters have been photographing themselves with cats. More recently, we've seen lots of pictures of Ukrainian and Russian soldiers with cats and dogs.
People who are trying to manipulate people already understand this. It just hasn't really moved into the scientific literature in the same way because people aren't measuring it. You can't know that there are stars out there if you don't have the right kind of telescope. So a lot of our work has simply been in measuring. It's been in building that telescope so we can actually see the stars.